This is my vacuum robot, which I'm calling Wally, because, you know, it is cleaning up my mess. And so far, Wally has been doing its job fantastically. But while watching a video from Mark Robar, in which he built a domino robot, I started to get curious about the way Wally moves. You see, vacuum robots use two wheels powered by motors and one additional freewheeling roller that moves along. This way they can move forwards or backwards by either rotating both motors clockwise or anti-clockwise. And of course they can also turn by only powering one motor or powering both motors in opposite directions. It is a pretty basic concept which I also utilized before while building an AI enhanced robot. The only problem is that all this turning around requires time and energy. And that is where Mark Robar's robot comes into play, which can move in any direction without having to turn around. It can do that because it is utilizing so-called Omniwheels, aka omnidirectional wheels, which I honestly never heard of before. So in this video, I want to build my own Omniwheel robot that can move in any direction, to not only find out how they differ from traditional robots, but also to see how hard it is to build such a robot. And spoiler warning, there were a few challenges along the way. So let's get started. This video is sponsored by Altium. If you ever designed a PCB before, then you know it can be quite frustrating when the software you're using is missing a certain feature. But luckily, there's the Altium Designer, which comes with all the features you could ever need when it comes to designing a circuit or PCB. If you want to give it a try for free, then simply have a look in the video description and follow the link there. To start off, I of course firstly did a Google search about Omniwheels and quickly found out that they are basically one big, almost round wheel that consists of several rollers all around it. This way, the wheel cannot only rotate the traditional way when powered by a motor, but it can also move orthogonally through the help of the rollers. Thus, by positioning three of such wheels in a circular arrangement with an angle of 120 degrees to one another, we can move the center of mass in any direction by powering the motors with a specific strength and direction. But more about this juicy math later. For now, I wanted to get my hands on such an Omniwheel, but sadly you can pretty much only get them from China, which means it would have taken weeks for them to arrive. So as already suspected, I had to make my own, and I started this process by firstly creating hand drawings with the most important dimensions. I then used those in Fusion 360 as a guideline in order to come up with a basic design. The roller not only comes with a 3mm hole in the middle, but also the main wheel structure, at the points where it holds the rollers. This way I can use a 27mm long piece of M3 threaded rod inserted into the roller in order to hold it in place inside the wheel. And let me tell you that the rollers turn beautifully this way. Then the design also comes with 18 holes, which are not only required to hold the two pieces of the wheel together, but they can also be used to attach two wheels together with one of them featuring a slight rotation, in order to minimize the dead zone of non-roller area. And of course, last but not least, there is a rectangle in the middle which will hold the shaft of my later utilized motors. And with the design aspect out of the way, I did a day worth of 3D printing, cut threaded rod to size with a big angle grinder and then a smaller Dremel for fine-tuning, cleaned the 3D prints, widened the roller holes a bit, and ultimately positioned all of them in the wheel and closed them up through the help of M4 nuts and bolts in order to create three beautiful Omniwheels. But of course, the wheels are only part of the story, which means next I got myself a big piece of plywood out of which I cut a circle with a diameter of 30cm. And after that was done, it was time to have a look at the motors I will be using, which are those DC motors with a gearbox attached to them. They work with a voltage of up to 12 volts, and of course we can change the rotational direction by simply swapping the plus and minus pole, and we can also fine adjust their speeds by varying the voltage between 0 and 12 volts. I will later use an H-bridge IC, which will be this L298N, in order to perform this direction change and speed adjustment. And since I will of course be needing 3 motors, I will need 2 of them, as well as an Arduino microcontroller who will not only be providing 3 individual PWM signals for varying the voltage going to the motors and thus adjusting their speeds, but also to set the current flow direction of the H-bridges, which controls the directions the motors spin. And while we're already at the electronic side of things, I utilized a USB Type-C power bank in combination with such a USB Type-C PD trigger board to get 12 volts portable power for the whole project. And with the electronics out of the way for now, I continued with the motors by measuring where their mounting holes are positioned. Once again, I used Fusion 360 to design a small mounting adapter for them, which I then 3D printed with PETG filament. After then marking the position of all adapters onto the robot and drilling holes for them, I secured all the motors in place. And before mounting the rest and wiring everything up, I glued a bit of wire at the edge of the circle so that nothing will fall off later. With that job being completed, I drilled holes for the motor drivers and another big one for the motor wires, through which I obviously thread them all through after soldering them to the motors. Afterwards, I connected the wires to the drivers, secured those in place, and created an Arduino Nano breakout board featuring PCB terminals, to which I then hooked up all of the driver pins and power according to the simplified schematic. If you want to build something similar, then have a look in the video description where you can find more details. But anyway, last but not least, I hooked up an RC receiver module to the system, which in combination with this huge RC remote will control the robots. The way this works is that after powering the receiver and having a look at channel 2 and 4 on the oscilloscope, we can see that the on time of this voltage pulse varies depending on how I push the control stick, with neutral being around 1.49 milliseconds, maximum being 1.9 milliseconds, and minimum being 1.08 milliseconds. We can later use those values in the code in order to let the robot move forwards, backwards, left, right, and everywhere in between. But to get to that point, I firstly had to add the wheels. And only at this point, I noticed that the motor shafts were actually a bit too short. But after doing a small gearbox hack, which involves turning around the shafts, it all came together very nicely, and it was time for the first test. With this code, I simply let the robot spin in circles alternately, and after uploading it, we can not only see the correct channel pulse time in microseconds, but the robot also does spin just like expected. So next, it was time for the real deal, by firstly setting a forward direction as well as markings for all the wheels, and then thinking about how fast and in which rotational direction the motors have to spin to move in a specific XY direction. You see, we are basically working with two-dimensional force vectors for each motor here, which come with a defined length and direction, and put together tell us where the robot will be moving. By splitting those vectors into an X and Y direction, we can determine a power value as well as rotational direction for each motor by using a bit of trigonometry. And I tried to encapsulate all that math into my final test codes. The first dry run did look pretty promising, but while doing the first proper test, I noticed a rather big problem. Now first off, it seems like the robot does follow the direction I'm pointing it to, but only after the wheels gain traction, which means my rollers are simply too slippery for this job. So I did the unthinkable, and printed smaller rollers onto which 13mm O-rings fit. And after replacing all the original ones with them, it was time for another test, which worked out way better and actually delivered some promising results. But there was once again a big problem, this time with the O-rings slipping off the rollers. Now I was not able to entirely fix this problem, and pretty soon after my motors also gave up working correctly, but during this short time of testing, I realized that such Omniwheels are pretty awesome. If we would add better rollers to mine, along with powerful BLDC motors whose position we can track, we could theoretically build a robot whose moving position we can very finely dictate, thus creating kind of like a movable CNC machine. Mark Robot definitely pulled this off in his video, because he really needed such accurate movements. But let's face it, this is all way harder to implement than just slapping on two motors with normal wheels and calling it a day. So yeah, Omniwheels are definitely worth it if you got a suitable task for them. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!